Praise God. Welcome, everyone. God sends His Son, they call Him Jesus. He came and I'm sorry. Can I start again? Can I go to the book? What's the number? Someone help me, please.
I'm sorry.
Please forgive me. I'm going to do this over. I'm going to do this for Jesus. God sent His Son, they called Him Jesus. He came to love. By my blood, an empty grave is there to prove my Savior lives, because He lives, oh, fear is gone, because He lives, troubles gotta move out of my way, because He lives, sadness cannot stay all day, because He lives, the grace of the righteousness, they will. My mother again, because He lives. Oh, is Jesus down in my soul, because He future, because He lives, this whole life is worth the living, because He lives.
Amen.
That was beautiful. Thank you, Sister Phyllis. Good evening, everybody. Okay, welcome back to our third night of Youth Week of Prayer, what we all need. What do we all need, guys? All right, amen. And please talk to me because I am very nervous over here. So talk to me, you know, make me feel comfortable. Okay. Hi, David. Tonight's topic is pray that I can totally overcome my sinful habits. How many of us out there have sinful habits? Amen. We all just shame the devil and told the truth. All right, this man right here, he's praying to stop his sinful habit of drinking. Let us pray before I start. Dear Lord, as I speak your word, help me to not be as nervous as I am, Lord. Help them to get something out of it, and help that at the end of this, we will all pray to get rid of our sinful habits. In my grace, amen. Okay. Stealing. Is stealing wrong? Is it a sin? All right. Fornication or adultery, is it a sin? Do you guys know what fornication and adultery is? Nobody needs an explanation? Great. Ooh. Oh. Okay, killing. Is killing a sin? All right, even though there are people out there that work to be killers, it is a sin. It is wrong. Witchcraft, voodoo, worshiping the devil, not worshiping the devil, summoning the dead people. Is it wrong? Is it a sin? All right. Domestic violence. Is it a sin? Okay. Bullying. How many of us out there have been a bully? Are bullies. Thank you for being honest. I've been a bully. It is wrong. It is a sin. It's not only to the person that's getting bullied, but the person that is the bully, they are sinning as well. Gambling or playing the lotto. Anybody gonna admit to doing that? Yes, it is a sin. It is wrong. Oh, most importantly, it's wrong because somebody else is losing at your expense of winning. Pornography. Is it a sin? Okay, you're not going to get it for that one. Who defines good and evil, Jesus or Satan? So is stealing a sin? Who defines fornication as a sin? Who defines gambling and stealing as a sin? Jesus or Satan? The Bible provides a clear answer. Okay, so it was a nice sunny day, you know, and this guy was riding his bike, and he was going, and then all of a sudden, this car swerves and hits him, right? The guy on the bike flies across the highway. The man in the car decides, well, he didn't decide, but his car flashes, well, gets into the guardrail, and the man on the bike doesn't die, but the guy in the car does die. Is it because the man on the bike is more righteous than the man in the car that he survived? Is it because the man in the car was more wicked that he died? Amen. The Bible says in Luke 13, verse 1 to 5, they were present at that season, some that told him of the Galileans, whose blood Pilate had mingled with their sacrifices. And Jesus answering said unto them, suppose ye that these Galileans were sinners above all the Galileans, because they suffered such things. So, is it because the Galileans were such sinners that they died in the sacrifice of their blood? No. I tell you nay, but except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish. Or those 18 upon whom the tower in Siloam fell and slew them, think ye that they were sinners above all men that dwelt in Jerusalem? So is it because they were so wicked and so, you know, sinful that they died in such a harsh way? It's not. I tell you nay, but except ye repent, ye shall all likewise perish. In Romans 3:23, the Bible says, for all have sinned and come short of the glory of God. So all of us in this room, you, we all have sinned. All these people in this crowd, they have sinned. All the people outside, they have sinned. The question is, when and how did we all sin? Adam and Eve chose sin voluntarily. We know that they became guilty because of their choice. What about us? Are we guilty because of Adam's sin, because we were born as descendants of Adam? Or is it B, are we guilty because we have inherited a fallen nature from him? Or rather, is it C, are we guilty because we choose to repeat Adam's sin? While attempting to unravel the mystery of sin, we should remember that all sin come under two main areas, which are sin as nature or sin as nature, as we are sinners at birth, or sin as choice. We became a sinner when we yield to temptation. Is this baby a sinner from the womb? Realize the Lord created you. Did the Lord create evil? The Bible presents three conditions for defining sin. The first, whosoever committeth sin transgresseth also the law, for sin is a transgression of the law. So is stealing transgression of the law? The second, therefore to him that knoweth to do good and doeth it not, to him it is sin. Is domestic violence a sin? And the third, and he that doubteth is damned if he eat, because he eateth not of faith. For whatsoever is not of faith is sin. So, this man, he was at this barbecue, right? And he was so hungry. And he saw two sandwiches left. One had bacon in it, and one just had, like, you know, sliced meat. So he was just looking at the second one like, man, this sandwich looks so good. But then he was like, this sliced meat could either be turkey or it could be ham. But then he's like, I mean, I'm hungry, so, you know, if I eat it, there's still a possibility that this is turkey. So, you know, he starts eating it, then he's like, nah, this is wrong. Let me go ahead and ask the lady across the street that made this sandwich, is this really turkey or is it really ham? So, you know, he goes over to her. She's like, nah, that's turkey. He's like, oh, man, thank you. So he's like, well, you know, I didn't sin. But technically he did, because it says, and he that doubteth is damned if he eat. So he ate the sandwich anyway. So even if she had said, I'm sorry, that's not turkey, that's ham, he already sinned, because before he knew that it was turkey, he already sinned because he wasn't faithful in his decision. God's word and law defines good and evil. The commandment says, thou shalt not kill. The commandments also say, thou shalt not commit adultery. It also says, thou shalt not steal. A sin of omission is committed, sin of omission is committed when a person omits, neglects, or fails to do something that is God's will or law. So if you fail to rest on the Sabbath day, you're committing the sin of omission. And a sin of commission is committed when a person does something that is against or opposed to God's will or law. So if we decide to steal, we are committing the sin of commission. The great Catholic theologian Augustine taught that original sin was the sin of the entire human race, not merely of Adam. This was so because all humans were seemingly present in Adam. When Adam sinned, the entire human race sinned and sinned with him. Were we in the Garden of Eden? So did we sin? Did we eat that fruit? Okay. So technically this is half true. We were with Adam because we are all descendants of Adam, but we all did not choose to eat the fruit. Then we need to ask ourselves the question, can sin be transmitted to our children through the umbilical cord? Doesn't know the answer. if this baby's mom is stealing while the baby's in the womb, is this baby a sinner because of his mom's sin? After the baby's born, if the mom is still lying and stealing, is this baby a sinner because that's her child? Okay, how many of us know the saying, like father, like son? The baby might look like his father, but if the father commits adultery, if the father steals, if the father does gambling, the baby is not committing the sin that his father has sinned. The soul that sinneth, it shall die. The son shall not bear the iniquity of the father, neither shall the father bear the iniquity of the son. The righteousness of the righteous shall be upon him, and the wickedness of the wicked shall be upon him. Ezekiel 18, verse 20. However, the concept of original sin predated Augustine, because even in Bible times, this concept was widely accepted by many. That is why the disciples asked him in John 9, verse 1-3, and as Jesus passed by, he saw a man which was blind from his birth. And his disciples asked him, saying, Master, who did sin, this man or his parents, that he was born blind? Jesus answered, neither. Both this man sinned, nor his parents sinned, nor his parents, but that the works of God should be made manifest in him. So Jesus is here telling them that not because the child was sinning inside of the mom's womb was he made blind. Was he born blind? That was just the will of God for him to be blind. As he grew older, that's when he became sinful. And here the blind man says in John 9, 31-34, now we know that God heareth not sinners, but if any man be a worshiper of God and doeth his will, him he heareth. Since the world began, was it not heard that any man opened the eyes of one that has been blind? If this man were not of God, he could do nothing. They, the Pharisees, answered and said unto him, thou wast altogether sin, and thus thou teachest, and they cast him out. Can we in the flesh have victory over sin? Remember, sin is a choice to rebel against God in either our thoughts, words, or actions. Having victory over sin is not yielding to temptation to sin in either our thoughts or actions. Of the sea, right? And this man said there are 789 sins. So some man was like, can I get a list? But I'm pretty sure by now there's like more than 789 sins. They're probably like 50. So because sin is pleasurable, sometimes Satan needs not to tempt us, and that is true, because sometimes we put ourselves in our own predicament where we end up sinning. Here we have Martin Luther. Right? And he was just going about his normal day, and out of nowhere, boom, there's a lightning storm. And Martin Luther was like, he was scared. He was like, man, Lord, can you please get me out of this? If you get me out of this, then I will end up, worshiping you and working for you. And out of nowhere, well, not out of nowhere, the Lord stopped the lightning storm. And being a man of his word, Martin Luther decided, okay, well, I'm going to have to keep my promise to the Lord. And he became a Catholic monk. The Catholic believe that, they believe that your sins, you carry them with you all the time. Right. So they would like beat themselves thinking like, okay, that's them paying for their sin. He just heard, that's painful, carrying all your sin with you. So one day he was reading the Bible, For the wages of sin is death, but the gift of God is eternal life through Jesus Christ our Lord. And here we have Mary Magdalene. You know, she was a sinner. But at the end of the day, who did not sin? Like, the Pharisees, they were ready to, like, kill her because they wanted to catch God in a lie. You know, like, oh. And then the Lord was like, whoever didn't sin, cast the first stone. And of course, he's the only one. But did he cast the first stone? No, he didn't. He was just like, go and sin no more. In Romans 8, verse 13, for if ye live after the flesh, ye shall die. But if you through the Spirit do mortify the deeds of the body, ye shall live. The purpose for our effort to overcome sin is not to earn salvation, but to honor God, because we love Him and we want to be like Him and please Him in all that we think and do in every area in our lives. Yield not into temptation, for yielding is a sin. Each victory will aid you some other to win. Fight manfully onward, dark passion subdued, look over to Jesus and He will carry you. So, how many of us tonight would like to pray to overcome our sinful habits? Thank you, David. Okay, can you stand up, please? Thank you. Let us pray.
Dear Lord, we want to thank you for the sermon that you have spoken through me, Lord. We want to ask you to help all of us in this room to overcome our sinful habits, whether it be pornography, stealing, or fornication, any of those things, Lord. Be with us and help us to give up those habits immediately.